The following is a free-for-download audiobook available on krishnapath.org. Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila, Chapter 4, Sri Madhavendra Puri's Devotional Service. In his Amrita Prabha Bhasya, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur gives the following summary of the fourth chapter. Passing along the path of Chaturbhoga and coming to Vidamanteshwar, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu reached the border of Orissa. On his way, he enjoyed transcendental bliss by chanting and begging alms in different villages. In this way, he reached the celebrated village of Remuna, where there is a deity of Gopinath. There, he related the story of Madhavendra Puri as he had heard it from his spiritual master, Ishwar Puri. The narration is as follows. One night, while in Govardhan, Madhavendra Puri dreamt that the Gopal deity was within the forest. The next morning, he invited his neighborhood friends to accompany him to excavate the deity from the jungle. He then established the deity of Sri Gopalji on top of Govardhan Hill with great pomp. Gopal was worshipped and the Anakut festival was observed. This festival was known everywhere and many people from the neighboring villages came to join. One night, the Gopal deity again appeared to Madhavendra Puri in a dream and asked him to go to Jagannath Puri to collect some sandalwood pulp and smear it on the body of the deity. Having received this order, Madhavendra Puri immediately started for Orissa. Traveling through Bengal, he reached Remuna village and there received a pot of condensed milk, kheer, to offer the deity of Gopinathji. This pot of condensed milk was stolen by Gopinath and delivered to Madhavendra Puri. Since then, the Gopinath deity has been known as Kshirakor Gopinath, the deity who stole the pot of condensed milk. After reaching Jagannath Puri, Madhavendra Puri received permission from the king to take out one mana of sandalwood and 8 ounces of camphor. Aided by 2 men, he brought these things to Remuna. Again, he saw in a dream that Gopal at Govardhan Hill desired that very sandalwood to be turned into pulp and mixed with camphor and smeared over the body of Gopinathji. Understanding that that would satisfy the deity of Govardhan, Madhavendra Puri executed the order and returned to Jagannath Puri. Srimad Chaitanya Mahaprabhu narrated this story for Lord Nityananda Prabhu and other devotees and praised the pure devotional service of Madhavendra Puri. When he recited some verses composed by Madhavendra Puri, he went into an ecstatic mood. But when he saw that many people were assembled, he checked himself and ate some sweet rice prasad. Thus he passed that night, and the next morning he again started for Jagannath Puri. Text 1. I offer my respectful obeisances unto Madhavendra Puri, who was given a pot of sweet rice stolen by Sri Gopinath, thereafter celebrated as Kshirakora. Being pleased by Madhavendra Puri's love, Sri Gopinath, or Gopal, the deity at Govardhan, appeared to the public vision. Purport. Bhaktivinoda Thakur annotates that this Gopal deity was originally installed by Vajra, the grandson of Krishna. Madhavendra Puri rediscovered Gopal and established him on top of Govardhan Hill. This Gopal deity is still situated at Nathadwar and is under the management of descendants of Ballabhacharya. The worship of the deity is very luxurious, and one who goes there can purchase varieties of prasad by paying a small price. Text 2. All glories to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, all glories to Nityananda Prabhu, all glories to Advaita Prabhu, all glories to all the devotees of Lord Chaitanya. Text 3 and 4. The Lord went to Jagannath Puri and visited Lord Jagannath's temple. He also met with Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. All these pastimes have been very elaborately explained by Vrindavan Das Thakur in his book Chaitanya Bhagavat. Text 5. By nature, all the activities of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu are very wonderful and sweet, and when they are described by Vrindavan Das Thakur, they become like a shower of nectar. Text 6. Therefore, I very humbly submit that since these incidents have already been nicely described by Vrindavan Das Thakur, I would be very proud to repeat the same thing, and this would not be very good. I do not have such powers. Text 7. I am therefore presenting in short codes all those events already described in the Chaitanya Mangala, now known as Chaitanya Bhagavat in Vrindavan Das Thakur, by Vrindavan Das Thakur. Text 8. Some of the incidents in his codes he did not describe elaborately, and so I shall try to describe them in this book. Text 9. Thus, I offer my respectful obeisances unto the lotus feet of Vrindavan Das Thakur. I hope that I will not offend his lotus feet by this action. Text 10. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu proceeded toward Jagannath Puri with four of his devotees, and he chanted the holy name of the Lord, the Hare Krishna mantra, with great eagerness. Text 11. Each day, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu personally went to a village and collected a great quantity of rice and other grains for the preparation of prasad. Text 12. There were many rivers on the way, and in each river there was a tax collector. They did not hinder the Lord, however, and he showed them mercy. Finally, he reached the village of Ramuna. Report. There is a railway station named Baleshwar, and 5 miles to the west is a village named Ramuna. The temple of Churakura Gopinath still exists in this village, and within the temple, the Samadhi tomb of Rakshikananda Prabhu, the chief disciple of Shyamananda Swami, Goswami, can still be found. Text 13. The deity of Gopinath in the temple of Ramuna was very attractive. Lord Chaitanya visited the temple and offered his obeisances with great devotion. Text 14. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu offered his obeisances at the lotus feet of the Gopinath deity, the helmet of flowers on the head of Gopinath fell down and landed on the head of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Text 15. When the deity's helmet fell upon his head, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu became very pleased, and thus he chanted and danced in various ways with his devotees. Text 16. All the servants of the deity were struck with wonder due to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's intense love, his exquisite beauty, and his transcendental qualities. Text 17. Because of their love for Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they served him in many ways, and that night the Lord stayed at the temple of Gopinath. Text 18. The Lord remained there because he was very eager to receive the remnants of sweet rice offered to the Gopinath deity, having heard a narration from his spiritual master, Ishwar Puri, of what had once happened there. Text 19. The deity was widely known as Churakura Gopinath, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told his devotees the story of how the deity became so famous. Text 20. Formerly, the deity had stolen a pot of sweet rice for Madhavendra Puri. Therefore, he became very famous as the Lord who stole the sweet rice. Text 21. Once, Sri Madhavendra Puri traveled to Vrindavan, where he came upon the hill known as Govardhan. Text 22. Madhavendra Puri was almost mad in his ecstasy of love of Godhead, and he did not know whether it was day or night. Sometimes he stood up, sometimes he fell to the ground. He could not discriminate whether he was in a proper place or not. Text 23. After circumambulating the hill, Madhavendra Puri went to Govindakund and took his bath. He then sat beneath a tree to take his evening rest. Text 24. While he was sitting beneath the tree, an unknown cowherd boy came with a pot of milk, placed it before Madhavendra Puri, and smiling, addressed him as follows. Text 25. Quote, please drink the milk I have brought. Why don't you beg some food to eat? What kind of meditation are you undergoing? End quote. Text 26. When he saw the beauty of that boy, Madhavendra Puri became very satisfied. Hearing his sweet words, he forgot all hunger and thirst. Text 27. Madhavendra Puri said, quote, who are you? Where do you reside? And how did you know that I was fasting? End quote. Text 28. The boy replied, quote, sir, I'm a cowherd boy and I reside in this village. In my village, no one fasts. Text 29. In this village, a person can beg food from others and thus eat. Some people drink only milk, but if a person does not ask for anyone for food, I supply him all his eatables. Text 30. Quote, the women who come here to take water saw you, and they supplied me with this milk and sent me to you. End quote. Text 31. The boy continued, I must go very soon to milk the cows, but I shall return and take back this pot and milk pot from you. Text 32. Saying this, the boy left the place, and indeed he suddenly could be seen no more, and Madhavendra Puri's heart was filled with wonder. Text 33. After drinking the milk, Madhavendra Puri washed the pot and put it aside. He looked toward the path, but the boy never returned. Text 34. Madhavendra Puri could not sleep. He sat and chanted the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, and at the end of the night he dozed a little and his external activities stopped. Text 35. In a dream, Madhavendra Puri saw the very same boy. The boy came before him and, holding his hand, took him to a bush in the jungle. Text 36. The boy showed Madhavendra Puri the bush and said, quote, I reside in this bush, and because of this I suffer very much from severe cold, rain showers, winds, and scorching heat. Text 37. Quote, please bring the people of the village and get them to take me out of this bush. Then have them situate me nicely on top of the hill. Text 38. Please construct a temple on top of that hill, the boy continued, and install me in that temple. After this, wash me with large quantities of cold water so that my body may be cleansed. Text 39. For many days I have been observing you, and I have been wondering, when will Madhavendra Puri come here to serve me? Text 40. I have accepted your service due to your ecstatic love for me. Thus I shall appear, and by my audience all fallen souls will be delivered. Text 41. My name is Gopal. I am the lifter of Govardhan Hill. I was installed by Vajra, and here I am the authority. Text 42. When the Mohammedans attacked, the priest who was serving me hid me in this bush in the jungle. Then he ran away out of fear of the attack. Text 43. Since the priest went away, I've been staying in this bush. It is very good that you have come here. Now just remove me with care. End quote. Text 44. Saying this, the boy disappeared. Then Madhavendra Puri woke up and began to consider his dream. Text 45. Madhavendra Puri began to lament, quote, I saw Lord Krishna directly, but I could not recognize him. End quote. Thus he fell down on the ground in ecstatic love. Text 46. Madhavendra Puri cried for some time, but then he fixed his mind on executing the order of Gopal. Thus he became tranquil. Text 47. After taking his morning bath, Madhavendra Puri entered the village and assembled all the people. Then he spoke as follows. Text 48. The proprietor of this village, Govardhan Dari, is lying in the bushes. Let us go there and rescue him from that place. Text 49. The bushes are very dense and we will not be able to enter the jungle. Therefore, take choppers and spades to clear the way. End quote. Text 50. After hearing this, all the people accompanied Madhavendra Puri with great pleasure. According to his directions, they cut down bushes, cleared a path, and entered the jungle. Text 51. When they saw the deity covered with dirt and grass, they were all struck with wonder and pleasure. Text 52. After they cleansed the body of the deity, some of them said, quote, the deity is very heavy. No one person can move him. End quote. Text 53. Since the deity was very heavy, some of the stronger men assembled to carry him to the top of the hill. Madhavendra Puri also went there. Text 54. A big stone was made into a throne, and the deity was installed upon it. Another big stone was placed behind the deity for support. Text 55. All the Brahmana priests of the village gathered together with 9 water pots and water from Govindakund Lake and was brought there and filtered. Text 56. When the deity was being installed, 900 pots of water were brought from Govindakund. There were musical sounds of bugles and drums and the singing of women. Text 57. During the festival at the installation ceremony, some people sang and some danced. All the milk, yogurt, and clarified butter in the village was brought to the festival. Text 58. Various foods and sweetmeats, as well as other kinds of presentations, were brought there. I am unable to describe all these. Text 59. The villagers brought a large quantity of tulsi leaves, flowers, and various kinds of garments. Then Sri Madhavendra Puri personally began the Abhishek bathing ceremony. Purport. In the Haribhakti Vilas, 6th Vilas, verse 30, it is stated that the deity should be bathed in water mixed with yogurt and milk, accompanied by the sounds of conch shells, bells, and other instruments, and the chanting of the mantra Om Bhagavate Vasudevaya Namaha, as well as the chanting of the Brahma Samhita verses beginning with Chintamani Prakarshad Mashu Kalpa Viksha Laksha Pradeshu Surabid Adipariyamtam. Text 60. After all inauspicious things were driven away by the chanting of the mantra, the deity's bathing ceremony started. First, the deity was massaged with a large quantity of oil so that his body became very glossy. Text 61. After the first bathing, further bathings were conducted with Panchagavya and then with Panchamrita. Then the Smahasnana was performed with ghee and water, which had been brought in 100 pots. Purport. The ingredients of Panchagavya are milk, yogurt, ghee, clarified butter, cow urine, and cow dung. All these items come from the cow, and therefore we can just imagine how important the cow is, since its stool and urine are required for bathing the deity. The Panchamrita consists of 5 kinds of nectar: yogurt, milk, ghee, honey, and sugar. The major portion of this preparation also comes from the cow. To make it more palatable, sugar and honey are added. Text 62. After the Mahasnana was finished, the deity was again massaged with scented oil and his body made glossy. Then the last bathing ceremony was performed with scented water kept within a conch shell. Purport. In his commentary on this occasion, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur quotes from the Hari Bhakti Vilas. Barley powder, wheat powder, vermilion powder, urd dal powder, and other powder preparation, and another powder preparation called avata, made by mixing banana powder and ground rice, are applied to the deity's body with a brush made from the hair at the end of a cow's tail. This produces a nice finish. The oil smeared over the body of the deity should be scented. To perform the Mahasnana, at least 2.5 mounds, about 24 gallons of water, are needed to pour over the body of the deity. Text 63. After the body of the deity was cleansed, he was dressed very nicely with new garments. Then sandalwood pulp, tulsi garlands, and other fragrant flower garlands were placed upon the body of the deity. Text 64. After the bathing ceremony was finished, incense and lamps were burned and all kinds of food offered before the deity. These foods included yogurt, milk, and as many sweetmeats as were received. Text 65. The deity was first offered many varieties of food, then scented drinking water in new pots, and then water for washing the mouth. Finally, pan mixed with a variety of spices was offered. Text 66. After the last offering of tambula and pan, Bhoga Arti was performed. Finally, everyone offered various prayers and then obeisances, falling flat before the deity in full surrender. Text 67. As soon as the people of the village had understood that the deity was going to be installed, they had brought their entire stocks of rice, dal, and wheat flour. They brought such large quantities that the entire surface of the top of the hill was filled. Text 68. When the villagers brought their stock of rice, dal, and flour, the potters of the village brought all kinds of cooking pots, and in the morning the cooking began. Text 69. 10 brahmanas cooked the food grains, and 5 brahmanas cooked both dry and liquid vegetables. Text 70. The vegetable preparations were made from various kinds of spinach, roots, and fruits collected from the forest, and someone had made bada and badi by mashing dal. In this way, the brahmanas prepared all kinds of food. Text 71. 5 to 7 men had prepared a huge quantity of chapatis, which were sufficiently covered with ghee, clarified butter, as were all the vegetables, rice, and dal. Text 72. All the cooked rice was stacked on palasa leaves, which were on new cloths spread over the ground. Text 73. Around the stacks of cooked rice were stacks of chapatis, and all the vegetables and liquid vegetable preparations were placed in different pots and put around them. Text 74. Pots of yogurt, milk, buttermilk, and shikharini, sweet rice, cream, and solid cream were placed alongside the vegetables. Purport. In this kind of ceremony, which is called anakuta, cooked rice is stacked like a small mountain for prasad distribution. Text 75. In this way, the anakuta ceremony was performed, and Madhavendra Puri Goswami personally offered everything to Gopal. Text 76. Many water pots were filled with scented water for drinking, and Lord Sri Gopal, who had been hungry for many days, ate everything offered to him. Text 77. Although Sri Gopal ate everything offered, still, by the touch of his transcendental hand, everything remained as before. Purport. The atheists cannot understand how the Supreme Personality of Godhead, appearing in the form of a deity, can eat all the food offered by his devotees. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Patram punshram palam tayam yomi bhakti parachiti tadaham bhakti aparitam astami prayatatmana. Quote, if one offers me, with love and devotion, a leaf, flower, fruit, or water, I will accept it. End quote. Bhagavad Gita 9:26. The Lord is Purna, complete, and therefore he eats everything offered by his devotees. However, by the touch of his transcendental hand, all the food remains exactly as before. It is the quality that is changed. Before the food was offered, it was something else. But after it is offered, the food acquires a transcendental quality. Because the Lord is Purna, he remains the same, even after eating. Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vishishite. The food offered to Krishna is qualitatively as good as Krishna. Just as Krishna is Avyaya, indestructible, the food eaten by Krishna, being identical with him, remains as before. Apart from this, Krishna can eat the food with any one of his transcendental senses. He can eat by seeing the food or by touching it. Nor should one think that it is necessary for Krishna to eat. He does not become hungry like an ordinary human being. Nonetheless, he presents himself as being hungry, and as such, he can eat anything and everything, regardless of quantity. The philosophy underlying Krishna's eating is understandable by our transcendental senses. When our senses are purified by constantly being engaged in the devotional service of the Lord, we can understand Krishna's activities, names, forms, qualities, pastimes, and entourage. Atasi Krishna namadi nabhavet griyam indiyai seva mukhe jivado swayameva svaratyada. Quote, no one can understand Krishna by the blunt material senses, but he reveals himself to the devotees, being pleased with them for their transcendental loving service unto him. End quote. Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 1.2.234. The devotees understand Krishna through revelation. It is not possible for a mundane scholar to understand Krishna and his pastimes through research work on the non-devotional platform. Text 78. How Gopal ate everything while the food remained the same was transcendentally perceived by Madhavendra Puri Goswami. Nothing remains a secret to the devotees of the Lord. Text 79. The wonderful festival installation of Sri Gopalji was arranged in one day. Certainly all this was accomplished by the potency of Gopal. No one but a devotee can understand this. Purport. The Krishna consciousness movement has spread all over the world within a very short time, within 5 years, and mundane people are very astonished at this. However, by the grace of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we can understand that everything is possible by the grace of Krishna. Why does Krishna have to take 5 years? In 5 days, he can spread his name and fame all over the world, like wildfire. Those who have faith and devotion in Krishna can understand these things happen so wonderfully by the grace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We are simply the instruments. In the fierce battle of Kurukshetra, Arjuna was victorious up within 18 days, simply because Krishna's grace was on his side. Yatra Yogeshwaro Krishna, Yatra Parto Dhanarjana. Tatar Shir Vijayo Bhutir Durva Nitir Matir Mama. Quote, wherever there is Krishna, the master of all mystics, and wherever there is Arjuna, the supreme archer, there will also certainly be opulence, victory, extraordinary power, and morality. That is my opinion, end quote. Bhagavad Gita, 1878. If the preachers of our Krishna consciousness movement are sincere devotees of Krishna, Krishna will always be there with them, because he is very kind and favorable to all his devotees. Just as Arjuna and Krishna were victorious in the Battle of Kurukshetra, this Krishna consciousness movement will surely emerge victorious if we but remain sincere devotees of the Lord and serve the Lord according to the advice of the predecessors, the six Goswamis, and other devotees of the Lord. As Narottam Das Thakur has stated, Tadera Charana Sevi Bhakti Sanivas Janamini Janamini Hai E Abhilas. The Krishna consciousness devotees must always desire to remain in the society of devotees. Bhakti Sanivas, they cannot go outside the Krishna conscious society or the movement. Within the society, we must try to serve the predecessors by preaching Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's cult and spreading his name and fame all over the world. If we attempt this seriously within the society, it will be successfully done. There is no question of estimating how this will happen in the mundane sense, but without a doubt, it happens by the grace of Krishna. Text 80. Madhavendra Puri offered water to Gopal for washing his mouth, and he gave him betel nuts to chew. Then, while arti was performed, all the people chanted, Jai, Jai, all glories to Gopal. Text 81. Arranging for the Lord's rest, Sri Madhavendra Puri brought a new cot, and over this he spread a new bedspread, and thus made the bed ready. Text 82. A temporary temple was constructed by covering the bed and all around with a straw mattress. Thus, there was a bed and a straw mattress to cover it. Text 83. After the Lord was laid down to rest on the bed, Madhavendra Puri gathered all the brahmanas who had prepared the prasad and said to them, quote, now feed everyone sumptuously from the children on up to the aged, end quote. Text 84. All the people gathered there sat down to honor the prasad, and by they took food. All the brahmanas and their wives were fed first. Purport. According to the Varnashram system, the brahmanas are always honored first. Thus, at the festivals, the brahmanas and their wives were first offered the remnants of food, and then others, kshatriyas, vaishyas, and shudras. This has always been the system, and is still prevalent in India, even though the caste brahmanas are not qualified. The system is still current due to the Varnashram's institutional rules and regulations. Text 85. Not only did the people of Govardhan village take prasad, but also those who came from other villages. They also saw the deity of Gopal and were offered prasad to eat. Text 86. Seeing the influence of Madhavendra Puri, all the people gathered there were struck with wonder. They saw that the Anakut ceremony, which had been performed before the time of Krishna, was now taking place again by the mercy of Sri Madhavendra Puri. Report. Formerly, at the end of Dwapara Yuga, all the cowherd men of Vrindavan had arranged to worship King Indra, but they gave this worship up following the advice of Krishna. Instead, they performed a ceremony whereby they worshiped the cows, brahmanas, and Govardhan Hill. At that time, Krishna expanded himself and declared, quote, I am Govardhan Hill, end quote. In this way, he accepted all the paraphernalia and foodstuff offered to Govardhan Hill. It is stated in Srimad Bhagavatam 10, 24, 26, 31, and 33. Pachyantam vivida paka shupanta palasadaya samyava pupashash kulya sarva dosha chagri yatam kalatmana bhagavata sakra darpam jighamsata proktam nishamya nandaya sadhav agni nantatadvacha tatacha vyada du sarvam yathaha madhusudana vachat yitva svati anyam tad dravyena giridvijan Aparitya Belin Sarvan Adita Yavansam Gavam Godhanani Puraskritya Gitim Chakshur Pradikshanam. Quote, prepare very nice foodstuffs of all descriptions from the grains and ghee collected from the for the jugga. Prepare sweet rice, or prepare rice, dal, then halva, pakora, puri, and all kinds of milk preparations like sweet rice, sweet balls, sundae, rasgul, and laddu. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, therefore advised the cowherd men to stop the Indra Jugga and prepare and begin the Govardhan Pooj to chastise Indra, who was very much puffed up at being the supreme controller of the heavenly planets. The honest and simple cowherd men, headed by Nanda Maharaj, accepted Krishna's proposal and executed in detail everything he advised. They performed Govardhan worship and circumambulation of the hill. According to the instruction of Lord Krishna, Nanda Maharaj and the cowherd men called in learned brahmanas and began to worship Govardhan Hill by chanting Vedic hymns and offering prasad. The inhabitants of Govardhan assembled together, decorated the cows, and gave them grass. Keeping the cows in front, they began to circumambulate Govardhan Hill. End quote. Text 87. All the brahmanas present on that occasion were initiated by Madhavendra Puri into the Vaishnava cult, and Madhavendra Puri engaged them in different types of service. Purport. In the scriptures, it is stated, Satkarma Nipuno Vipro Mantra Tantra Visharada Avaishnava. Even though a caste brahmana or a qualified brahmana is expert in the occupational duties of a brahmana, he is not necessarily a Vaishnava. His duties are mentioned as six brahminical engagements. Patana means that a brahmana must be conversant with the Vedic scriptures. He must also be able to teach others to study Vedic literatures. This is patana. He must also be expert in worshipping different deities and in performing the Vedic rituals, jaga or yajana. On account of this yajana, the brahmanas, being the head of society, performs all the Vedic rituals for the kshatriyas, vaishyas, and shudras. This is called yajana, or assisting others in performing ceremonies. The two remaining items are dana and pratigraha. The brahmanas accept all kinds of contributions, pratigraha, from his followers, mainly the kshatriyas, vaishyas, and shudras. But he does not keep all the money. He keeps only as much as required and gives the balance to others in charity, dana. In order for such a qualified brahmana to worship the deity, he must be a Vaishnava. Thus, the Vaishnava's position is superior to that of the brahmana. This example is given by Madhavendra Puri, confirms that even though a brahmana may be very expert, he cannot become a priest or servitor of the Vishnumurti unless he is initiated in Vaishnava mantra. After installing the deity of Gopal, Madhavendra Puri initiated all the brahmanas into Vaishnavism. He then allotted the brahmanas different types of service to the deity from 4 in the morning till 8 at 10, till 10 at night, from Mangal Arti to Sayan Arti. There must be at least 5 or 6 brahmanas to take care of the deity. 6 artis are performed in the temple, and food is frequently offered to the deity and the prasad distributed. This is the method for worshiping the deity according to the rules and regulations set by the predecessors. Our Sampradaya belongs to the disciplic succession of Madhavendra Puri, who belonged to the Madhva Sampradaya. We are in the disciplic succession of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who was initiated by Sri Ishwara Puri, a disciple of Madhavendra Puri's. Our Sampradaya is therefore called the Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya. As such, we must carefully follow in the footsteps of Sri Madhavendra Puri and observe how he installed the Gopal deity on the top of Govardhan Hill and how he arranged to perform the Anakut ceremony in only one day, and so forth. Our installation of deities in America and in wealthy countries of Europe should be carried out in terms of Sri Madhavendra Puri's activities. All the servitors of the deity must be strictly qualified as brahmanas and specifically must engage in the Vaishnava custom of offering as much prasad as possible and distributing it to the devotees who visit the temple to see the Lord. Text 88. After taking rest, the deity must be awakened at the end of the day, and immediately some food and some water must be offered to him. Purport. This offering is called Vaikali Bhoga, food offered at the end of the day. text 89. When it was advertised throughout the country that Lord Gopal had appeared atop Govardhan Hill, all the people from neighboring villages came to see the deity. Text 90. One village after another was pleased to beg Madhavendra Puri to allot them one day to perform the Anakut ceremony. Thus, day after day, the Anakut ceremony was performed for some time. Text 91. Sri Madhavendra Puri did not eat anything throughout the day, but at night, after laying the deity down to rest, he took a milk preparation. Text 92. The next morning, the rendering of service to the deity began again, and people from one village arrived with all kinds of food grains. Text 93. The inhabitants of the village brought the deity of Gopal as much food, grains, ghee, yogurt, and milk as they had in their village. Purport. Anagrita Dadi and Dugda are food grains, ghee, yogurt, and milk. Actually, they are the basis of all food. Vegetables and fruits are subsidiary. Hundreds and thousands of recipes can be made out of grains, vegetables, ghee, milk, and yogurt. The food offered to Gopal in the Anakut ceremony contained only these five ingredients. Only demoniac people are attracted to other types of food, of which we will not even mention in this connection. We should understand that in order to prepare nutritious food, we require only grains, ghee, yogurt, and milk. We cannot offer anything else to the deity. The Vaishnava, the perfect human being, does not accept anything not offered to the deity. People are often frustrated with national food policies, but from the Vedic scriptures we find that if there is sufficient cows and grains, the entire food problem is solved. The Vaishnavas, peoples engaged in agriculture and commerce, are therefore recommended in Bhagavad Gita to produce grains and give protection to cows. Cows are the most important animal because they produce the miracle food, milk, from which we can prepare ghee and yogurt. The perfection of human civilization depends on Krishna consciousness, which recommends deity worship. Preparations made from vegetables, grains, milk, ghee, and yogurt are offered to the deity and then distributed. Here we can see the difference between the East and the West. People who came to see the deity of Gopal brought all kinds of food to offer the deity. They brought all the food they had in stock, and they came before the deity not only to accept the prasad for themselves, but to distribute it to others. The Krishna consciousness movement vigorously approves this practice of preparing food, offering it to the deity, and distributing it to the general population. This activity should be extended universally to stop sinful eating habits as well as to other behavior befitting only demons. A demonic civilization will never bring peace within the world. Since eating is the first necessity in human society, those engaged in solving the problems of preparing and distributing food should take lessons from Madhavendra Puri and execute the Anakuta ceremony. When the people take to eating only prasad offered to the deity, all the demons will be turned into Vaishnavas. When the people are Krishna conscious, naturally the government will be also. A Krishna-conscious man is always a very liberal well-wisher of everyone. When such men head the government, the people will certainly be sinless. There will be no longer be disturbing demons. It is then and then only that a peaceful condition can prevail in society. Text 94. The next day, almost like before, there was an Anakut ceremony. All the Brahmanas prepared foodstuffs and Gopal accepted them. Text 95. The ideal place to execute Krishna consciousness is Rajabhumi or Vrindavan, where the people are naturally inclined to love Krishna and Krishna is naturally inclined to love them. Purport. In Bhagavad Gita, it is said, Ye tamam prapadyante tam shtaiva bhajami aham. There is a responsive cooperation between the Supreme Lord Krishna and his devotees. The more a devotee sincerely loves Krishna, the more Krishna reciprocates, so much so that a highly advanced devotee can talk with Krishna face to face. Krishna confirms this in Bhagavad Gita. Ye tesham satyate yuktanam bhajatam pratipurvagam dadami buddhi yogam tam ye mam vipiyantite. Quote, to those who constantly devoted and worship me with love, I give the understanding by which they can come to me, end quote. Bhagavad Gita 10.10. The actual mission of human life is to understand Krishna and return home back to Godhead. Therefore, one who is sincerely engaged in the service of the Lord with love and faith can talk with Krishna and receive instructions by which he can speedily return home back to Godhead. Today, many scholars defend the science of religion, and they have some conception of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But religion without practical experience of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is no religion at all. Srimad Bhagavatam describes this as a form of cheating. Religion means abiding by the order of Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. If one is not qualified to talk with him and take lessons from him, how can one understand the principles of religion? Thus, talks of religion or religious experience without Krishna consciousness are a useless waste of time. Text 96. Throngs of people came from different villages to see the deity of Gopal, and they took Mahaprasad sumptuously. When they saw the super excellent form of Lord Gopal, all their lamentation and unhappiness disappeared. Text 97. All the villages in neighboring Vrajabhumi, Vrindavan, became aware of the appearance of Gopal, and all the people from these villages came to see him. Day after day, they all performed the Anakuta ceremony. Text 98. In this way, not only the neighboring villages, but all the other provinces came to know of Gopal's appearance. Thus, people came from all over, bringing a variety of presentations. Text 99. The people of Mathura, who are very big capitalists, also brought various presentations and offered them before the deity in devotional service. Text 100. Thus, countless presentations of gold, silver, garments, scented articles, and eatables arrived. The store of Gopal increased daily. Text 101. One very rich Kshatriya of the royal order constructed a temple. Someone made cooking utensils, and someone constructed boundary walls. Text 102. Each and every family residing in the land of Vrajabhumi contributed one cow. In this way, thousands of cows became the property of Gopal. Purport. This is the way to install the deity, construct the temple, and increase the property of the temple. Everyone should be enthusiastic to contribute to the construction of the temple for the deity, and everyone should also contribute food for the distribution of prasad. The devotees should preach the gospel of devotional service and thus engage people in practical service to the deity. Wealthy people can also be attracted to take part in these activities. In this way, everyone will be spiritually inclined, and the entire society will be converted into Krishna consciousness. The desire to satisfy the material senses will automatically diminish, and the senses will become so purified that they will be able to engage in bhakti, devotional service to the Lord. Rishikena Rishikesha Shevanam Bhakti Ruchite. By serving the Lord, one's senses are gradually purified. This the engagement of one's purified senses in the Lord's in the service of Lord Hrishikesh is called bhakti. When the dormant propensity for bhakti is awakened, one can understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead as he is. Bhakti Amam Abhijananti Yavanyas Chasmi Tattata. Bhagavad Gita 18:55. This is the process of giving humanity the chance to awaken Krishna consciousness. Thus people can perfect their lives in all respects. Text 103. Eventually, two brahmanas in the renounced order arrived in from Bengal, and Madhavendra Puri, who liked them very much, kept them in Vrindavan and gave them all kinds of comforts. Text 104. These two were then initiated by Madhavendra Puri, and he entrusted them with the daily service of the Lord. This service was performed continuously, and the worship of the deity became very gorgeous. Thus, Madhavendra Puri was very pleased. Report. The Goswamis started many temples, namely the Govinda Temple, Gopinath, Madan Mohan, Radha Damodar, Shamasundar, Radha Raman, and Gokulananda. The disciples of the Goswamis were entrusted with the Seva Puj, deity worship of these temples. It was not that the disciples were family members of the original Goswamis. Most of the Goswamis were in the renounced order of life, and Jiva Goswami in particular was a brahmachari. At present, Seva Itas assume the title Goswami on the basis of their being engaged as Sevaitas of the deity. The Sevaitas have also have inherited their portions, now assume proprietorship of the temples, and some of them are selling the deity's property as if it were their own. However, the temples did not originally belong to these Sevaitas. Text 105. In this way, the deity worship in the temple was very gorgeously performed for 2 years. Then one day, Madhavendrapuri had a dream. Text 106. In his dream, Madhavendrapuri saw Gopal, who said, quote, "My bodily temperature still has not decreased. Please bring sandalwood pulp from the Malaya province and smear the pulp over my body to cool me." Purport. The deity of Gopal had been buried within the jungle for many years, and although he was installed and offered thousands of pots of water, he still felt very hot. He therefore asked Madhavendrapuri to bring sandalwood from the Malaya province. Sandalwood produced in Malaya is very popular. That province is situated in the western Ghat, and the hill Nilagiri is sometimes known as Malaya Hill. The word Malaya Ja is used to indicate the sandalwood produced in the Malaya province. Sometimes the word Malaya refers to the modern country of Malaysia. Formerly, this country also produced sandalwood, but now they have found it profitable to produce rubber trees. Although the Vedic culture was once prevalent in Malaysia, now all the inhabitants are Mohammedans. The Vedic culture is now lost in Malaysia, Java, and Indonesia. Text 107. Quote, "Bring sandalwood pulp from Jagannath Puri. Kindly go quickly. Since no one else can do it, you must." Text 108. After having this dream, Madhavendrapuri became very glad due to ecstasy of love of Godhead, and in order to execute the command of the Lord, he started east toward Bengal. Text 109. Before leaving, Madhavendrapuri made all arrangements for regular deity worship, and he engaged different people in various duties. Then, taking up the order of Gopal, he started for Bengal. Text 110. When Madhavendrapuri arrived at the house of Advaita Acharya in Sandipur, the Acharya became very pleased upon seeing the ecstatic love of Godhead manifest in Madhavendrapuri. Text 111. Advaita Acharya begged to be initiated by Madhavendrapuri. After initiating him, Madhavendrapuri started for South India. Purport. In this connection, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur comments that Advaita Acharya took initiation from Madhavendrapuri, who was a sannyasi in the disciplic succession of the Madhva Sampradaya. According to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, "Kibra Vipra Kibra Nasi Shudra Kenanai Ye Krishna Tattva Veda Se Guru Hoy." Quote, "A person may be a brahmana, sannyasi, sudra, whatever, but if he is well conversed in the science of Krishna, he can become a guru." End quote. Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya 8.128. This statement is supported by Sri Madhavendrapuri. According to the Pancharatra injunction, only householder brahmana can initiate, others cannot. When a person is initiated, it is assumed that he has become a brahmana. Without being initiated by a proper brahmana, one cannot be converted into a brahmana. In other words, unless one is a brahmana, he cannot make another a brahmana. A grihastha brahmana partaking of the Varnashram Dharma institution can secure various types of paraphernalia to worship Lord Vishnu through his honest labor. Actually, people beg to be initiated by these householder brahmanas just to become successful in the Varnashram institution or to become free from material desires. It is therefore necessary for a spiritual master in the grihastha ashram to be a strict Vaishnava. The spiritual master from the sannyas order has very little opportunity to perform archana, deity worship. But when one accepts a spiritual master from the traditional sannyasis, the principle of deity worship is not at all neglected. To implement this conclusion, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave us his opinion in the verse Kibra Vibra Kibra Nasi, etc. This indicates that the Lord understood the weakness of society in its maintaining that only grihastha brahmana should be a spiritual master. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu indicated that it does not matter whether a spiritual master is a grihastha or a sannyasi or even a shudra. A spiritual master simply must be conversant in the essence of the shastra. He must understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Only then can one become a spiritual master. Diksha actually means initiating a disciple with transcendental knowledge by which he becomes freed from all material contamination. Text 112. Going to South India, Sri Madhavendrapuri visited Ramuna, where Gopinath is situated. Upon seeing the beauty of the deity, Madhavendrapuri was overwhelmed. Text 113. In the corridor of the temple from which people generally viewed the deity, Madhavendrapuri chanted and danced. Then he sat down there and asked a brahmana what kinds of foods they offered to the deity. Text 114. From the excellence of the arrangements, Madhavendrapuri understood by deduction that only the best food was offered. Text 115. Madhavendrapuri thought, quote, I shall inquire from the priest what foods are offered to Gopinath so that by making arrangements in our kitchen, we can offer similar foods to Sri Gopal. End quote. Text 116. When the Brahmana priest was questioned in this matter, he explained in detail what kinds of foods were offered to the deity of Gopinath. Text 117. The Brahmana priest said, quote, in the evening, the deities offered sweet rice in 12 earthen pots. Because the taste is as good as nectar, Amrita, it is named Amrita Kali. Text 118. Quote, this sweet rice is celebrated throughout the world as Gopinath's cheer. It is not offered anywhere else in the world. End quote. Text 119. While Madhavendrapuri was talking with the Brahmana priest, the sweet rice was placed before the deity as an offering. Hearing this, Madhavendrapuri thought as follows. Text 120. If, without my asking, a little sweet rice is given to me, then I can taste it and make a similar preparation to offer my Lord Gopal. End quote. Text 121. Madhavendrapuri became greatly ashamed when he desired to taste the sweet rice, and he immediately began to think of Lord Vishnu. While he was thus thinking of Lord Vishnu, the offering was completed and the aarti ceremony began. Text 122. After the RT was finished, Madhavendrapuri offered his obeisances to the deity and left the temple. He did not say anything more to anyone. Text 123. Madhavendrapuri avoided begging. He was completely unattached and indifferent to material things. He would not beg. If someone offered him some food, he would eat. Otherwise, he would fast. Purport. This is the Paramahansa stage, the highest stage for a sannyasi. A sannyasi can beg from door to door just to collect food, but a Paramahansa who has taken Aichitavritti or Ajagaravritti does not ask anyone for food. If someone offers him food, he eats. Aichitavritti means being accustomed to refrain from begging, and Ajagaravritti indicates one who is compared to a python, the big snake who makes no effort to acquire food, but rather allows food to come automatically within its mouth. In other words, Paramahansa simply engages in exclusively in the service of the Lord without caring even for eating or sleeping. It is stated about the six Goswamis, Nidrahara Viharakadi Vijato. In the Paramahansa stage, one conquers the desire for sleep, food, and sense gratification. One remains a humble, meek mendicant engaged in the service of the Lord day and night. Madhavendrapuri had attained this Paramahansa stage. Text 124. A Paramahansa like Madhavendrapuri is always satisfied in the loving service of the Lord. Material hunger and thirst cannot impede his activities. When he desired to taste a little sweet rice offered to the deity, he considered that he had committed an offense by desiring to eat what was being offered to the deity. Purport. It is advisable that food being offered to the deity be covered when taken from the kitchen to the deity room. In that way, others may not see it. Those who are not accustomed to following the advanced regulative devotional principles may desire to eat the food, and that is an offense. Therefore, no one should be given a chance to even see it. However, when it is brought before the deity, it must be uncovered. Seeing the food uncovered before the deity, Madhavendrapuri desired to taste a little of it so that he could prepare a similar sweet rice for his Gopal. Madhavendrapuri was so strict, however, that he considered this to be an offense. Consequently, he left the temple without saying anything to anyone. The Paramahansa is therefore called Vijata Sadguna. He must conquer the six material qualities, Kama, Krodha, Jat, Lobha, Moha, Matsara, and Kshuda, Trishna. Lust, anger, greed, illusion, enviousness, hunger, and thirst. Text 125. Madhavendrapuri left the temple and sat down in the village marketplace, which was vacant. Sitting there, he began to chant. In the meantime, the temple priest laid the deity down to rest. Purport. Although Madhavendrapuri was not interested in eating and sleeping, his interest in chanting the Maha Mantra was as acute as if he were an aspiring transcendentalist rather than a Paramahansa. This means that even in the Paramahansa stage, one cannot give up chanting. Haridas Thakur and the Goswamis were all engaged in chanting a fixed number of rounds. Therefore, chanting on beads is very important for everyone, even though one may become a Paramahansa. This chanting can be executed anywhere, either outside or inside the temple. Madhavendrapuri even sat down in a vacant marketplace to perform his chanting. As stated by Srinivas Acharya in his prayers to the Goswamis, Nama Gana Nati Bi. A Paramahansa devotee is always engaged in chanting and rendering loving service to the Lord. Chanting the Lord's holy names and engaging in his service are identical. And stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam 7.5.23, there are 9 kinds of devotional service. Hearing, Shravanam, chanting, Kirtanam, remembering, Vishnu Smaranam, serving, Padasevanam, worship of the deity, Archanam, praying, Vandanam, carrying out orders, Dasyam, serving him as a friend, Shakyam, and sacrificing everything to the Lord, Atmanivedanam. Although each process appears distinct, when one is situated on the absolute platform, he can see that they are identical. For instance, hearing is as good as chanting, and remembering is as good as hearing or chanting. Similarly, engaging in deity worship is as good as chanting, hearing, or remembering. The devotee is expected to accept all 9 processes of devotional service, but even if only 1 process is properly executed, he can still attain the highest position, Paramahansa, and go back home, back to Godhead. Text 126. Finishing his daily duties, the priest went to take rest. In a dream, he saw the Gopinath deity come to talk to him, and he spoke as follows. Text 127. Quote, please get up and open the door of the temple. I have kept 1 pot of sweet rice for the sannyasi Madhavendrapuri. Text 128. Quote, the pot of sweet rice is just behind my cloth curtain. You did not see it because of my tricks. Text 129. A sannyasi named Madhavendrapuri is sitting in the vacant marketplace. Please take this pot of sweet rice from behind me and deliver it to him. End quote. Text 130. Awakening from the dream, the priest immediately arose from bed and thought it wise to take a bath before entering the deity's room. He then opened the temple door. Text 131. According to the deity's direction, the priest found the pot of sweet rice behind the cloth curtain. He removed the pot and mopped up the place where it had been kept. He then went out of the temple. Text 132. Closing the door of the temple, he went to the village with the pot of sweet rice. He called out in every stall in search of Madhavendrapuri. Text 133. Holding the pot of sweet rice, the priest called, will he whose name is Madhavendrapuri please come and take this pot? Gopinath has stolen this pot for you, end quote, report. The difference between the absolute truth and relative truth is explained here. Lord Gopinath has openly declared herein that he is a thief. He had stolen the pot of sweet rice, and this was not kept a secret because his act of stealing is a source of great transcendental bliss. In the material world, theft is criminal, but in the spiritual world, the Lord's stealing is a source of transcendental bliss. Mundane rascals who cannot understand the absolute nature of the personality of Godhead sometimes call Lord Krishna immoral, but they do not know that his seemingly immoral activities, which are not kept secret, afford pleasure to the devotees. Not understanding the transcendental behavior of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, these rascals slur his character and immediately fall into the category of miscreants, rascals, lowest among men, demons, and those whose knowledge is taken away by the illusory energy. Krishna explains in Bhagavad Gita, Namam duskritano mudha prapadyante naradama maya prakritiyan asurambhava asrita. Quote, those miscreants who are grossly foolish, lowest among mankind, whose knowledge is stolen by illusion, and who partake of the atheistic nature of demons, do not surrender unto me. End quote. Bhagavad Gita 7.15. Mundane rascals cannot understand that whatever Krishna does, being absolute in nature, is all good. This quality of the Lord is explained in Srimad Bhagavatam 10th canto. One may consider certain acts of a supremely powerful person to be immoral by mundane calculations, but this is actually not the case. For example, the sun absorbs water from the surface of the earth, but it does not absorb water only from the sea. It also absorbs from filthy sewers and ditches containing urine and other impure substances. The sun is not polluted by absorbing such water. Rather, the sun makes the filthy place pure. If a devotee approaches the Supreme Personality of Godhead for an immoral or impure purpose, he nonetheless becomes purified. The Lord does not become infected. In Srimad Bhagavatam, it is stated that if one approaches the Supreme Lord even out of lust, anger, or fear, Kaman Krodam Bhayam, he is purified. Srimad Bhagavatam 10:29-15. The gopis, being young girls, approached Krishna because he was a beautiful young boy. From the external point of view, they approached the Lord out of lust, and the Lord danced with them at midnight. From the mundane point of view, these activities may appear immoral because a married or unmarried young girl cannot leave home to mix with a young boy and dance with him. Although this is immoral from a mundane viewpoint, the activities of the gopis are accepted as the highest form of worship because it was Lord Krishna whom they approached with lusty desires in the dead of night. But these things cannot be understood by non-devotees. One must understand Krishna in truth. One should use his common sense and consider that if simply by chanting Krishna's holy name one is purified, then how then can the person Krishna be immoral? Unfortunately, mundane fools are accepted as educational leaders and are offered exalted posts for teaching irreligious principles to the general populace. This is explained in Srimad Bhagavatam 7.5.31. Anda yatandar upalemaniya. Blind men are trying to lead other blind men. Due to the immature understanding of such rascals, common men should not discuss Krishna's pastimes with the gopis. The non-devotee should not even discuss his stealing sweet rice for his devotees. It is warned that one should not even think about these things. Although Krishna is the purest of the pure, mundane people thinking of Krishna's pastimes that appear immoral themselves become polluted. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu therefore never publicly discussed Krishna's dealings with the gopis. He used to discuss these dealings only with three confidential friends. He never discussed Rasa Lila publicly as the professional reciters do, although they do not understand Krishna or the nature of the audience. However, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu encouraged the public chanting of the holy name on a huge scale for as many hours as possible. Text 134. The priest continued, quote, would the sannyasi whose name is Madhavendra Puri please come and take this pot of sweet rice and enjoy the prasad with great happiness? You are the most fortunate person within these three worlds. End quote. Purport. Here is an example of a personal benediction by Krishna's immoral activity. By Gopinath stealing for his devotee, the devotee becomes the most fortunate person within the three worlds. Thus, even the Lord's criminal activities make his devotee the most fortunate person. How can a mundane rascal understand the pastimes of Krishna and judge whether he is moral or immoral? Since Krishna is the absolute truth, there are no mundane distinctions such as moral and immoral. Whatever he does is good. That is the real meaning of, quote, God is good, end quote. He is good in all circumstances because he is transcendental outside the jurisdiction of this material world. Therefore, Krishna can be understood only by those who are already living in the spiritual world. This is corroborated in Bhagavad Gita. Mam chio babachane na bhakti yogena sevate saganan samatityayatan brahma bhuyaya kalpate. Quote, one who engages in full devotional service who does not fall down in any circumstance at once transcends the modes of material nature and thus comes to the level of Brahman, end quote. Bhagavad Gita 14:26. One who is engaged in unalloyed devotional service to the Lord is already situated in the spiritual world, Brahma Bhuyaya Kalpate. In all circumstances, his activities and dealings with Krishna are transcendental and are thus not understandable by mundane moralists. It is therefore better not to discuss such activities among mundane people. It is better to give them the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra so that they will gradually be purified and thus then come to understand the transcendental activities of Krishna. Text 135. Hearing this invitation, Madhavendra Puri came out and identified himself. The priest then delivered the pot of sweet rice and offered his obeisances, falling flat before him. Purport. A brahmana is not supposed to offer his obeisances by falling flat before anyone because a brahmana is considered to be in the highest caste. However, when a brahmana sees a devotee, he offers his dandavats. This brahmana priest did not ask Madhavendra Puri whether he was a brahmana, but when he saw that Madhavendra Puri was such a bona fide devotee that Krishna would even steal for him, he immediately understood the position of a saint. As stated by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Kiva Bivra Kiva Nyasi Shudra Kena Naya Krishna Tattva Veda Se Guru Hoy, Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya 8.21.28. Had the Brahmana priest been an ordinary Brahmana, Gopinath would have not talked with him in a dream, since the deity spoke to both Nadavendra Puri and the Brahmana priest in dreams. Practically speaking, they were on the same platform. However, because Madhavendra Puri was a senior sannyasi Vaishnava, a Paramahansa, the priest immediately fell flat before him and offered obeisances. Text 136. When the story about the pot of sweet rice was explained to him in detail, Sri Madhavendra Puri at once became absorbed in ecstatic love of Krishna. Text 137. Upon seeing the ecstatic loving symptoms manifest in Madhavendra Puri, the priest was struck with wonder. He could understand why Krishna became so much obliged to him, and he saw that Krishna's action was befitting. Purport. A devotee can bring Krishna perfectly under his control. This is explained in Srimad Bhagavatam. Ajita jito pi ashitaish trilokyam. Srimad Bhagavatam 10.14.3. Krishna is never conquered by anyone, but a devotee can conquer him through devotional service. As stated in Brahma Samhita 5.33. Videshu durlabha madurlabha bhatma bhakto. One cannot understand Krishna simply by reading Vedic literature. Although all Vedic literature is meant for understanding Krishna, one cannot understand Krishna without being a lover of Krishna. Therefore, along with the reading of Vedic literature, Shvadhyaya, one must engage in the devotional service of the deity, Archanavidhi. Together, these will enhance the devotee's transcendental understanding of devotional service. Shravana Nadi Chute Sudha Chitte Kariye Odoi. Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya 22.107. Love of Godhead is dormant and within everyone's heart, and if one simply follows the standard process of devotional service, it is awakened. But foolish mundane people who simply read about Krishna mistakenly think that he is immoral or criminal. Text 138. A priest offered his obeisances to Madhavendra Puri and returned to the temple. Then, in ecstasy, Madhavendra Puri ate the sweet rice offered to him by Krishna. Text 139. After this, Madhavendra Puri washed the pot and broke it into pieces. He bound all the pieces in his outer cloth and kept them nicely. Text 140. Each day, Madhavendra Puri would eat one piece of that earthen pot, and after eating it, he would immediately be overwhelmed with ecstasy. These are wonderful stories. Text 141. Having broken the pot and bound the pieces in his cloth, Madhavendra Puri began to think, quote, "The Lord has given me a pot of sweet rice, and when the people hear of this tomorrow, there will be great crowds," end quote. Text 142. Thinking this, Sri Madhavendra Puri offered his obeisances to Gopinath and on the spot and left Ramuna before morning. Text 143. Walking and walking, Madhavendra Puri finally reached Jagannath Puri, which is also known as Neelachala. There he saw Lord Jagannath and was overwhelmed with loving ecstasy. Text 144. When Madhavendra Puri was overwhelmed in the ecstasy of love of Godhead, sometimes he stood up and sometimes he fell to the ground. Sometimes he laughed, danced, and sang. In this way, he enjoyed transcendental bliss by seeing the Jagannath deity. Text 145. When Madhavendra Puri came to Jagannath Puri, people were aware of his transcendental reputation. Therefore, crowds of people came and offered him all sorts of respect and devotion. Text 146. Even though one may not like it, reputation, as ordained by providence, comes to him. Indeed, one's transcendental reputation is known throughout the entire world. Text 147. Being afraid of his reputation, Pratista, Madhavendra Puri fled from Ramuna. But the reputation brought by love of Godhead is so sublime that it goes along with the devotee as if following him. Purport. Almost all the conditioned souls within the material world are envious. Jealous people generally turn against one who automatically attains some reputation. This is the nature of jealous people. Consequently, when a devotee is fit to receive worldly reputation, he is envied by many people. This is quite natural. When a person out of humility does not desire fame, people generally think him quite humble and consequently give him all kinds of fame. Actually, a Vaishnava does not hanker after fame or great reputation. Madhavendra Puri, the king of Vaishnavas, bore his reputation, but he wanted to keep himself outside of the vision of the general populace. He wanted to cover his real identity as a great devotee of the Lord, but when people saw him overwhelmed in ecstasy of love of Godhead, they naturally gave credit to him. Actually, a first-class reputation is due Madhavendra Puri because he was a most confidential servitor of the Lord. Sometimes a sahajya presents himself as being void of desires for reputation, pratistha, in order to become famous as a humble man. Such people cannot actually attain the platform of celebrated Vaishnavas. Text 148. Madhavendra Puri wanted to leave Jagannath Puri because the people were honoring him as a great devotee. However, this threatened to hinder his collecting sandalwood for the Gopal deity. Text 149. Shri Madhavendra Puri told all the servants of Lord Jagannath and all the great devotees there the story of the appearance of Sri Gopal. Text 150. When all the devotees at Jagannath Puri heard that the Gopal deity wanted sandalwood, in great pleasure, they all endeavored to collect it. Text 151. Those who were acquainted with government officers met with him and begged for camphor and sandalwood, which they collected. Purport. It appears that Mayalajya Chandan, sandalwood, and camphor were used for the Jagannath deity. The camphor was used in his arti, and the sandalwood was used to smear his body. Both these items were under government control. Therefore, the devotees had to meet with the government officials, informing them of all the details. They attained permission to take the sandalwood and camphor outside Jagannath Puri. Text 152. One brahmana and one servant were also given to Madhavendra Puri just to carry the sandalwood. He was also given the necessary traveling expenses. Text 153. To get past the toll collectors on the way, Madhavendra Puri supplied with the necessary release papers from government officers. The papers were placed in his hand. Text 154. In this way, Madhavendra Puri started for Vrindavan with a burden of sandalwood, and after some days, he again reached the village of Ramuna and the Gopinath temple there. Text 155. When Madhavendra Puri reached the temple of Gopinath, he offered his respectful obeisances many times at the lotus feet of the Lord. In the ecstasy of love, he began to dance and sing without cessation. Text 156. When the priest of Gopinath saw Madhavendra Puri again, he offered all respects to him and, giving him the sweet rice prasad, made him eat. Text 157. Madhavendra Puri took rest that night in the temple, but toward the end of the night he had another dream. Text 158. Madhavendra Puri dreamed that Gopal had came before him and said, quote, O Madhavendra Puri, I have already received all the sandalwood and the camphor. Text 159. Now just grind all the sandalwood together with the camphor and then smear the pulp on the body of Gopinath daily until it is finished. Text 160. There is no difference between my body and Gopinath's body. They are one and the same. Therefore, if you smear the sandalwood pulp on the body of Gopinath, you will naturally also smear it on my body. Thus, the temperature of my body will be reduced. Purport. Gopal was situated in Vrindavan, which was far away from Ramuna. In those days, one had to pass through provinces governed by the Mohammedans, who sometimes hindered travelers. Considering the trouble of his devotee, Lord Gopal, the greatest well-wisher of his devotees, ordered Madhavendra Puri to smear the sandalwood pulp over the body of Gopinath, which was non-different from the body of Gopal. In this way, the Lord relieved Madhavendra Puri from trouble and inconvenience. Text 161, you should not hesitate to act according to my order. Believing in me, just do what is needed, end quote. Text 162. After giving these instructions, Gopal disappeared and Madhavendra Puri awoke. He immediately called for all the servants of Gopinath and they came before him. Text 163, Madhavendra Puri said, smear the body of Gopinath with this camphor and sandalwood I have brought for Gopal in Vrindavan. Do this regularly every day. Text 164. If the sandalwood pulp is smeared over the body of Gopinath, then Gopal will be cooled. After all, the Supreme Personality of Godhead is completely independent. His order is all-powerful. End quote. Text 165, the servants of Gopinath became very pleased to hear that in the summer all the sandalwood pulp would be used to anoint the body of Gopinath. Text 166, Madhavendrapuri said, these two assistants will regularly grind the sandalwood and you should also get two other people to help. I shall pay their salary. Text 167, in this way Gopinath ji was supplied ground sandalwood pulp daily. The servants of Gopinath were very pleased with this. Text 168. In this way, the sandalwood pulp was smeared over the body of Gopinath until the whole stock was finished. Madhavendrapuri stayed there until that time. Text 169. At the end of the summer, Madhavendrapuri returned to Jagannath Puri, where he remained with great pleasure during the whole period of Chaturmasya. Purport. The Chaturmasya period begins in the month of Ashada, June, July, from the day of Ekadasi, known as Shayana Ekadasi, in the fortnight of the waxing moon. The period ends in the month of Kartik, October, November, on the Ekadasi day known as Uttana Ekadasi, in the fortnight of the waxing moon. This four-month period is known as Chaturmasya. Some Vaishnavas also observe it from the full moon day of Ashada until the full moon day of Kartik. That is also a period of 4 months. This period, calculated by the lunar months, is called Chaturmasya, but others also observe Chaturmasya during the solar month of Shravana to Kartik. The whole period, either lunar or solar, takes place during the rainy season. Chaturmasya should be observed by all sections of the population. It does not matter whether one is a grihastha or a sannyasi. The observance is obligatory for all ashrams. The real purpose behind the vow taken during these 4 months is to minimize the quantity of sense gratification. This is not very difficult. In the month of Shravana, one should not eat spinach. In the month of Bhadra, one should not eat yogurt. In the month of Ashvina, one should not drink milk. One should not eat fish or other non-vegetarian food during the month of Kartik. A non-vegetarian diet means meat and fish. Similarly, Masura dal and Urd dal are also considered non-vegetarian. These two dals contain a great amount of protein, and food rich in protein is considered non-vegetarian. On the whole, during the four-month period of Chaturmasya, one should practice giving up all food intended for sense enjoyment. Text 170. Thus, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu personally praised the nectarian characteristics of Madhavendrapuri, and while he related all this to the devotees, he personally relished it. Text 171. Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked Nityananda Prabhu to judge whether there was anyone within the world as fortunate as Madhavendrapuri. Text 172. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, quote, Madhavendrapuri was so fortunate that Krishna personally appeared before him on the plea of delivering milk. Three times the Lord gave orders to Madhavendrapuri in dreams. Text 173. Being obliged because of the loving affairs of Madhavendrapuri, Lord Krishna himself appeared as the Gopal deity, and accepting his service, he liberated the whole world. Text 174. On account of Madhavendrapuri, Lord Gopinath stole the pot of sweet rice. Thus he became famous as Chorakora, the thief who stole the sweet rice. Text 175. Madhavendrapuri smeared the sandalwood pulp over the body of Gopinath, and in this way he was overpowered with love of Godhead. Text 176. In the provinces of India governed by the Mohammedans, there was much inconvenience in traveling with sandalwood and camphor. Because of this, Madhavendrapuri might have gotten into trouble. This became known to the Gopinath deity. Text 177. The Lord is very merciful and attached to his devotees. So when Gopinath was covered with sandalwood pulp, Madhavendrapuri's labor became successful. Text 178. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu placed the standard of Madhavendrapuri's intense love before Nityananda Prabhu for judgment. Quote, all his loving activities are uncommon, end quote, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said. Quote, indeed, one is struck with wonder to hear of his activities, end quote, report. When the living entity feels spiritual separation from Krishna, Krishna Viraha, he has achieved the prime success of life. When one becomes disinterested in material things, he is simply experiencing the other side of attraction for material things. However, feeling separation from Krishna and engaging in the service of the Lord to fulfill his mission constitute the best example of love of Krishna. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to point out this intense love of Krishna exhibited by Madhavendra Puri. All Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's devotees later followed in the footsteps of Madhavendra Puri, serving the Lord without personal considerations. Text 179. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu continued, quote, Sri Madhavendra Puri used to remain alone. He was completely renounced and always very silent. He was uninterested in anything, everything material, and for fear of talking about mundane things, he always lived without a companion. Text 180. After receiving the transcendental orders of Gopal, this great personality traveled thousands of miles just to collect sandalwood by begging. Text 181. Although Madhavendra Puri was hungry, he would not beg food to eat. This renounced person carried a load of sandalwood for the sake of Sri Gopal. Text 182. Without considering his personal comforts, Madhavendra Puri carried one mound, about 82 pounds of sandalwood, and 20 tolas, about 8 ounces of camphor, to smear over the body of Gopal. This transcendental pleasure was sufficient for him. Text 183. Since there were restrictions against taking the sandalwood out of the Orissa province, the toll official confiscated the stock, but Madhavendra Puri showed him the release papers given by the government and consequently escaped difficulties. Text 184. Madhavendra Puri was not at all anxious during the long journey to Vrindavan through the provinces governed by the Mohammedans and filled with unlimited numbers of watchmen. Text 185. Although Madhavendra Puri did not have a farthing with him, he was not afraid to pass by the toll collectors. His only enjoyment was in carrying the load of sandalwood to Vrindavan for Gopal. Text 186. This is the natural result of intense love of Godhead. The devotee does not consider personal inconveniences or impediments. In all circumstances, he wants to serve the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Purport. It is natural for those who have developed intense love for Krishna not to care for personal inconveniences and impediments. Such devotees are simply determined to execute the order of the Supreme Personality of Godhead or his representative, the spiritual master. In all circumstances, even amidst the greatest dangers, they undeviatingly carry on with the greatest determination. This definitely proves the intense love of the servitor, as stated in Srimad Bhagavatam Tat Te Nikumpam Shushamikshyash Mana. Those who seriously desire to get free from the clutches of material existence, who have developed intense love for Krishna, are worthy candidates for going back home, back to Godhead. An intense lover of Krishna does not care for any number of material discomforts, scarcity, impediments, or unhappiness. It is said that when one sees apparent unhappiness or distress in a perfect Vaishnava, it is not at all unhappiness for him. Rather, it is transcendental bliss. In the Shikshasaka, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has also instructed, Ashlishyavad Param Ratam, an intense lover of Krishna, is never deviated from his service despite all difficulties and impediments brought before him. Text 187. Sri Gopal wanted to show how intensely Madhavendra Puri loved Krishna. Therefore, he asked him to go to Nilachala to fetch sandalwood and camphor. Text 188. Quote, with great trouble and after much labor, Madhavendra Puri brought the load of sandalwood to Ramuna. However, he was still very pleased. He discounted all the difficulties. Text 189. To test the intense love of Madhavendra Puri, Gopal, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, ordered him to bring the sandalwood from Nilachal, and when Madhavendra Puri passed this examination, the Lord became very merciful to him. Text 190. Such behavior exhibited in loving service between the devotee and the devotee's lovable object, Sri Krishna, is transcendental. It is not possible for a common man to understand. Common men do not even have the capacity. End quote. Text 191. After saying this, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu read the famous verse of Madhavendra Puri. That verse is just like the moon. It has spread illumination all over the world. Text 192. By continuous rubbing, the aroma of Malaya sandalwood increases. Similarly, by considering this verse, its importance increases. Text 193. As the Kashtubha Mani is considered the most precious of valuable stones, this verse is similarly considered the best of mellow poems. Text 194. Actually, this verse was spoken by Srimati Radharani herself, and by her mercy only was it manifest in the words of Madhavendra Puri. Text 195. Only Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has tasted the poetry of this verse. No fourth man is capable of understanding it. Purport. This indicates that only Srimati Radharani, Madhavendra Puri, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu are capable of understanding the purport of this verse. Text 196. Madhavendra Puri recited this verse again and again at the end of his material existence. Thus uttering this verse, he attained the ultimate goal of life. Text 197. O my Lord, O most merciful Master, O Master of Mathura, when shall I see you again? Because of my not seeing you, my agitated heart has become unsteady. O most beloved one, what shall I do now? End quote. Purport. The uncontaminated devotees who strictly depend on the Vedanta philosophy are divided into four sampradayas, or transcendental parties. Out of the four sampradayas, the Sri Madhvacharya sampradaya was accepted by Madhavendra Puri. He took sannyas according to parampara, the disciplic succession. Beginning from Madhvacharya down to the spiritual master of Madhavendra Puri, the acharya named Lakshmipati, there was no realization of devotional service in conjugal love. Sri Madhavendra Puri introduced the conception of conjugal love for the first time in the Madhvacharya Sampradaya, and this conclusion of the Madhvacharya Sampradaya was revealed by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he toured South India and met the Tattvavadis, who supposedly belonged to the Madhvacharya Sampradaya. When Sri Krishna left Vrindavan and accepted the kingdom of Mathura, Srimati Radharani, out of ecstatic feelings of separation, expressed how Krishna can be loved in separation. Thus, devotional service in separation is central to this verse. Worship in separation is considered by the Gaudiya Madhva Sampradaya to be the topmost level of devotional service. According to this conception, devotee thinks of himself as very poor and neglected by the Lord. Thus, he addresses the Lord as Dina Daridra Nata, as Madhavendra Puri did. Such an ecstatic feeling is the highest form of devotional service. Because Krishna had gone to Mathura, Srimati Radharani was very much affected, and she expressed herself thus, quote, my dear Lord, because of your separation, my mind has become overly agitated. Now tell me, what can I do? I'm very poor, and you are very merciful, so kindly have compassion upon me, and let me know when I shall see you. End quote. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was always expressing the ecstatic motions of Srimati Radharani that she exhibited when she saw Uddhava at Vrindavan. Similar feelings, as experienced by Madhavendra Puri, are expressed in this verse. Therefore, Vaishnavas in the Gaudiya Madhva Sampradaya say that the ecstatic feelings expressed by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu during his appearance came from Madhavendra Puri through Ishvara Puri. All the devotees are in the line of the Gaudiya Madhva Sampradaya accept these principles of devotional service. Text 198. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recited this verse, he immediately fell to the ground unconscious. He was overwhelmed and had no control over himself. Text 199. When Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu fell to the ground in ecstatic love, Lord Nityananda took him on his lap. Crying, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then got up again. Text 200. Exhibiting ecstatic emotions, the Lord began to run here and there, making resounding noises. Sometimes he laughed, sometimes he cried, sometimes he danced and sang. Text 201. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu could not recite the whole verse. He simply said, ai dina, repeatedly. Thus he could not speak, and profuse tears were in his eyes. Text 202. Trembling, perspiration, jubilant tears, shock, fading of bodily luster, disappointment, moroseness, loss of memory, pride, joy, and humility were all visible in Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's body. Purport. In the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Jadya is explained as loss of memory brought about by severe shock due to separation from the beloved. In that state of mind, One loses all concern for loss and gain, hearing and seeing, as well as other considerations. This marks the preliminary appearance of illusion. Text 203. This verse uncovered the door of ecstatic love, and when was it was exhibited, all the servants of Gopinath saw Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu dance in ecstasy. Text 204. When many people crowded around Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he regained his external senses. In the meantime, he offered to the deity. The offering to the deity had been finished, and there was a resounding RT performance. Text 205. When the deities were laid down to rest, the priest came out of the temple and offered all 12 pots of sweet rice to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Text 206. When all the pots of sweet rice, remnants left by Gopinath, were placed before Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he became very pleased. In order to feed the devotees, he accepted 5 of them. Text 207. The 7 remaining pots were pushed forward and delivered to the priest. Then the 5 pots of sweet rice the Lord had accepted were distributed among the 5 devotees, and they ate the prasad. Text 208. Being identical with the Gopinath deity, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had already tasted and eaten the pots of sweet rice, yet just to manifest devotional service, he again ate the pots of sweet rice as a devotee. Text 209. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu passed that night as the temple engaged in congregational chanting. In the morning, after seeing the Mangalarti performance, he departed. Text 210. In this way, Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu personally tasted with his own mouth the transcendental qualities of Gopalji, Gopinath, and Sri Madhavendrapuri. Text 211. Thus, I have described both the transcendental glories of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's affection for his devotees and the highest limit of ecstatic love of God. Text 212. One who hears this narration with faith and devotion attains the treasure of love of Godhead at the lotus feet of Sri Krishna. Text 213. Praying at the lotus feet of Sri Rupa and Sri Raghunath, always desiring their mercy, I, Krishnadas, narrate Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, following in their footsteps. Thus end the Bhaktivedanta purports to the Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila 4th chapter, describing Sri Madhavendra Puri's devotional service.